In this video, we'll demonstrate the entire rebuilding process of the Aisin Warner UA80E torque converter, starting with disassembling the torque converter and ending with its assembly. First, let's disassemble the torque converter down to the lockup unit. Let's start disassembling the lockup unit. In order to open the torque converter lockup unit, it is necessary to carefully cut off the crimp on the piston along the outer diameter of the safety washer, preserving the outer diameter of the safety washer as much as possible. After we've removed the crimp, we remove the safety washer. To remove the retaining ring, we need to compress the piston using the pneumatic press or the lockup preload tester. We remove the retaining ring. Let's remove the piston. A hardened thrust washer will be installed behind the retaining ring. Using thrust washers of varying thicknesses allows for adjustment of the clearance in the lockup unit. The sealing ring, which is inserted into the groove of the torque converter piston, must be replaced. Once we remove the piston, we gained access to the internal components of the lockup unit. We remove the spring clutch. On the internal parts of the torque converter body, engine side, two rubber rings are installed in annular grooves. They must be replaced during repairs. Next, we remove the friction plates. We remove the pressure steel plate. Pay attention to wear. Let's start assembling the lockup unit. We begin assembly by installing the O-rings. We install the second O-ring into the lower groove on the piston hub. We install the pressure steel plate with internal teeth. Then, new friction plates are installed in the following order. First, install the friction plate with external teeth. Second, install the friction plate with internal teeth. Third, install the friction plate with external teeth. And lastly, the fourth one, we install a friction plate with internal teeth. Please note that the friction material side of all four plates must face the torque converter body. Next, install the O-ring into the piston groove. Apply grease to the three installed O-rings. Install the spring clutch. Install the piston, aligning the protrusions with the corresponding recesses. We install a hardened thrust washer. Secure the piston with a retaining ring. After assembling the lockup unit, it is necessary to check the clearance in it. Next, to prevent the retaining ring from opening spontaneously, when the torque converter rotates, the previously removed safety washer is installed. It can be secured in one of the following two ways. Using punching on the piston body at the indicated points, or fixing at three points using argon welding. Once we've assembled the lockup unit, we can begin assembling the torque converter and welding its body. Before welding, the clearance in the lockup unit must be adjusted.